I remember my knees shaking, and I was saying, holy smokes, I'm going into war. This is war. I was a bit scared. Once we went in, and they started firing at us, the fear went away. Everything became smooth, deathly quiet in the cockpit. And then I got hit.
Everett Alvarez was the first American airman to be shot out of the sky over North Vietnam, and the first to be imprisoned there.
You have such a rare perspective on all this, having been a prisoner of war for 7 or 8 years. Why is it important to you that the war be understood?
Well, Vietnam is a very complex experience. I just think people have different views and different perspectives, and it's very difficult to explain in its entirety. You cannot explain Vietnam in one setting, in one documentary, in one movie. And so I think over a period of time, history will show and get a better picture of it, so that it can be presented to the next generations in a more comprehensible manner.
Do you and do other former POWs, I know it's a small group of people, and other veterans you know, do you feel that what you did in serving your country is appreciated?
I think in our case, as a POW, I think that, yes, our efforts were appreciated from the beginning, and because we went through such a unique experience. But I always felt sorry for the individuals. I felt bad for them because their efforts were well-meant. They were patriotic. It was their duty to serve. And then having the, quote, image of the bad guy in that war, carrying the burden of the war themselves, I thought was just an injustice to them. But one thing we can agree on is after it was over, we can come to recognize that the Vietnam veteran was as loyal, as patriotic as his father, as his grandfather.
And from the Vietnamese perspective, do you think today you have a better understanding
I think we're getting there. I think that we appreciate each other as individuals, as human beings, as well as combatants.
Have you forgiven them for what they did to you?
I never hated or never had hatred for the Vietnamese people. I certainly didn't like some of the guards, and I certainly don't ever want to see or ever wanted to see the officers who gave the guards the orders to treat me badly and torture and the hardships that we had to go through and I had to go through. But amongst ourselves, we had a saying, someday we're going to go home. These poor people have to stay here.
I'm curious about what you think the lessons are.
I think there are lessons out of every war, whether it's a major war or a minor war. I mean, we've had wars all along in our history. You know, people forget from one generation to the next, and you have to relearn these lessons. That's just the way things are.